I don't need your attribution. If you want my content, pay me for my content. I'm getting hit by riot police. I'm getting locked up. I'm sweating for that content, and you just right-clicking and pasting.
Okay, so what do you want added?
And I don't want added, I want removed.
What?
Using someone else's work without attribution does not count towards plagiarism. Using somebody's work against their license, their copyright license that they have on their website, I would call it plagiarism.
Oh, yeah. Okay, what is plagiarism? Plagiarism is taking someone's work and passing it as your own. That is the definition of plagiarism. Okay, so the moment you don't pass it as your own, it stops being plagiarism.
Under the Commons Creative, it clearly says that you cannot republish for a commercial purpose. Because I make money from traffic, you make money from traffic, we're both commercial. So attribution doesn't pay my rent.
Yeah.
So in that effect, let's respect the Commons Creative part of it. Because it's my license, it's my changing conditions, not yours. So it's theft.
For those who are so particular about their work not being reproduced or so, I think it's good to put a disclaimer at the end of whatever you have to say, no reproduction or something. A disclaimer. If someone does not respect that disclaimer, then you can then be on their tail.
Using someone's work without attribution acknowledgement, you know what? There's something tenuous about this statement. I don't know whether there's need to change it or not. It's clear, but it's also not very clear.
People take things from BBC and say this was first said on BBC.
Yeah.
They do that. People take things from any publication that's already in the public domain. As long if you take in part or in whole, you have to then acknowledge that this was first published here. This is international best practice.
I think you need to help us as well as Bust of TV. We've been having such kind of problems whereby we put our skits on YouTube, because YouTube now you can monetize, is it?
Yeah.
So you find people take our stuff. They open their YouTube channels, they post on their links, on their channels. They get traffic to their channels as well. Then they get money from YouTube. So we're finding it hard in terms of how can we kind of protect our stuff.
I think also, as much as we might be having all these wars, which I understand, also as practitioners and people who have the content we want to protect, let's learn how to protect. If it's a site, I know so many sites that took an copy and copy, right, click what I like and paste it elsewhere. You know who needs a link. There are those. If we can learn those kind of if we can learn those kind of activities, it helps. But I know they can be bypassed, but let's put them. What on his website? It's very clean. And I don't think I put over. There is now legal action that you can take. If you haven't put this,
like, there are two things here. This is complete work without remuneration, comma, attribution or acknowledgement is plagiarism for your code. For your code. And is therefore unlawful and unethical. Yes.
I think that issue of traffic is very technical, especially if you are talking with bloggers. We are all online creators, right? So I think one component, instead of just crediting, I think you can talk of things like hyperlink. William, I'm sure you can support me. When I have a hyperlink going to your website, that means I'm equally generating Google posts and transport and traffic to your website.
This is how Pindula wants it. Cool, cool. Pindula wants it the legal way. However, if we left illegal things slipping there, it is illegal for you to come to my website, take my content, and even say I stole this from Pindula, or say attribution Pindula. That is illegal.